गुड मॉर्निंग सेवंथ क्लास.
यस स्टूडेंट्स, यस्टरडे वी हैव स्टार्टेड चैप्टर नंबर 1 फॉर रिकैप्चुलाइजेशन. सो टुडे आई एम कंटिन्यूइंग विद दैट. यस्टरडे वी हैव डिस्कस सो मेनी एरियाज वेयर वी फाइंड द इनइक्वालिटी. नाउ इक्वालिटी इन इंडियन डेमोक्रेसी. यस माय डियर स्टूडेंट, द इंडियन कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन called every person or recognize every person as a equal person before the law, mean everybody is equal the law, and it means everyone is having equal rights and opportunities. But if I'm talking about social inequality, so the government is improving or giving us many areas where we try to cope up this social inequality, but still the conditions they are not very good. So every person, as I told you, is equal before the law. It means even the president of the country or a domestic worker are equal against the law. Here I want to share one incident with you that have you just listened about the first IPS officer? Yes, my dear friends, I am talking about Kiran Bedi. When she became the inspector she became a cop in the police, so once she just impound the car of Mrs. Indira Gandhi. At that time when she was the Prime Minister, Mrs. Indira Gandhi. So what does this incident shows? This incident shows that everybody is equal before the law. And why she impound the car of Indira Gandhi? Because the car was wrongly parked in an area, or I think it was parked in no parking zone. So such condition was there at that time. Still, she impounded the car and took the car into the police station. So such kind of condition was there. What does it show? That everybody is equal before the law. For the better understanding, I have taken some of the pics. And before going to that, I want to discuss some of the efforts taken by the government. As I've told you about the midday meal scheme, it also the government, with introducing this scheme, they try to remove the discrimination, maybe on the basis of caste, or you can say the on the basis of economic status. So issues of inequality, they are not in only in Indian democracy. Some are also in other countries also, but the things may be a little bit different. Like in Indian society, we are having most prevalent inequalities. They are on the basis of caste, religion and economic status. These are the three main, you can say. And in other countries, they are having the discrimination on the basis of color also. Here the discrimination is somewhere, but not properly you can say that we consider anyone an unequal on the basis of color. But in other countries, the color based inequalities are still there. As one of the cases has been discussed in chapter, that is of the Rosa Parks. She was a citizen of the United States of America because she was an African American lady in that area. So because she refused to give the seat to the white people, that was the white men, so at that time the revolution was started. She raised her voice against the white color people, because at that time the color based discrimination were there in America also. So at that time, no black color people were allowed to take admission in the schools, in the schools that there the white people they were studying. So as she refused to give up her seat on a bus to white men, and the date was the 1st December 1955, and her refusal started a agitation against the inequality in against the African American people, and that movement was called as the civil rights movement. And in 1964, this discrimination was banned by the side of the government, that on the basis of race, religion or color should not be entertained by the government. So a majority of African American continue to be among the poorest in the country. So most African American children can only afford to attend government school that have fewer facilities and poorly qualified teachers as compared to the white student who either go to the private schools or live in the areas where the government schools are as highly rated as private schools. Means I have already told you that they were not allowed to read in that school, the black people. So there, this is a great challenge against the against the inequality, that no country can be described as being completely democratic. Whether in the books or in a written form, we are having all such things with us. But if we are talking about the social status, on the basis of social status, so inequality is still there in our society. So for this, I have taken the pics which shows for the gender equality is a human right, not a female fight. Yes, my dear students, it's the best quote, because everywhere we are saying that women are equal to men. No, my dear students, everybody is equal and everybody is getting equal rights. Like this picture also shows the equality and equity. The equality means all are there, but equity means all are getting equal rights and opportunities to have the things. Freedom of religion means everybody is free to adopt any religion. No official religion is forced by the side of the government. Again, a pick on religion that shows that in spite of different religions, we still are equal. Now, this picture shows the different inequality of different colors, that we as a human beings belong to same family but of different colors, so this should not be discriminated. So it shows the different color of people. So as I've told you, this should not be discriminated, means the people should not be discriminated or considered unequal to the due to the different caste, religion, color, creed, etc. So this is all for the day. And next we will do in the next chapter. Up to that, you have to revise the questions again and be ready for the PA1.